In Hebrews chapter 11, the author of Hebrews, it is the lists the many heroes of the faith, and it's a wonderful passage, a favorite of many. And I wanted to read a few verses at the end of the chapter where the author discusses some of the unnamed people. He names the people in the early part, and then he has some things about the unnamed people. And just to read a few verses here, he says, "And others had trial of cruel mockings and scourging, yea, moreover of bonds and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn asunder, they were tempted, were slain with the sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and in mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. And these all, having obtained a good report through faith, received not the promise, God having provided some better thing for us, that they without us should not be made perfect. Wherefore, seeing we are also compassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses." And the author here is describing people in the Old Testament, as he mentions there. But I think as I read this passage and the testimony I want to give, I think it could also be describing what happened in the next 2,000 years. And this may seem like an odd testimony, but this morning I wanted to just thank the Lord for our Baptist heritage and how God has used that in my life. About 10 years ago, Pastor Vogelin asked me if I would give a brief Baptist history moment in Sunday school each Sunday, and I've always loved history, so I jumped at the opportunity. But what I didn't know was going to happen was it kind of began a journey for me that God used to really work on my heart and change me. When you read the stories of the old saints and the difficult things that they went through. It's amazing to me how they drew closer and closer to God through these terrible hardships. I don't want to do a history lesson, but there's always been a people of God that believe the Bible and live their lives the way that Jesus and the New Testament saints did. And they weren't always visible. They weren't always in groups or churches that we could see, but they were always there. And they had different names through history. Sometimes they're called all kinds of things, Novatians and Waldensians, and they were called Dissenters, and they were called Anabaptists. And actually that name was a name of derision. They were hated, and they called them Anabaptists about 500 years ago. But these were our Baptist forefathers. And essentially the unsaved world and maybe mostly the religious world hated them because of their beliefs, and they believed just like we do. And so the hardships that the author is describing here happened to them also. And so as I began to read the testimonies of these men and women, how entire groups of people were wiped out, some people, entire generations living in caves, for instance, in Italy, because they weren't allowed to live in the cities because of what they believed. I would say that hundreds of thousands were burned alive at the stake. Just imagine that for their beliefs. And the thing that struck me as I read, and this is what God worked in my heart about, is as you read these men, these dear Christians, they would be forgiving the people that were lighting the fire under them, literally at the moment. They were forgiving the people that turned them in, that lied about them and lied to the authorities and turned them in. And they would forgive those people, and they would turn to the crowds as they gathered, and they would just plead with them to turn to Jesus as they died. And these testimonies just really affected me as I've read them over these years. And so God used these things, and a couple of things I just think of that I would say, you know, God used this idea of forgiveness and how I should forgive people. You know, we live in a day when we get offended if somebody doesn't say hi to us as they pass in the hall, you know, and yet think what these people did, what happened to these people, and they were able to forgive them, and God's used that in my life to forgive, you know, to follow His word and be much better about that. I think of patience. I'm not a patient person. I'm an impatient person. I want to get ahead of God sometimes. And yet, when you read the Bible and you read these testimonies, God says so much about patience. Pastor Dameron talked about this a few weeks ago, and how that it's almost a spiritual attribute. How God wants us to be patient and wait on Him. And I know about these people as they prayed that God would maybe take this persecution away from them or relieve the pain as they were burned alive. And, you know, sometimes God didn't answer that prayer. Probably most of the time God didn't answer that prayer. And yet maybe God was trying to teach them something by not answering the prayer. And God wants to teach me things by not answering prayer and making me wait on Him. You know, when these people were it's easy for us to look back, I think, at least I do, and I think, you know, sometimes when we look back at them and they were going through these things, they weren't thinking, oh, that's okay, I'm helping help create a free country in the future. They weren't thinking that at all. You know, their homes are being destroyed, their wives, their children were being cut down and executed. Some of these things God used to change the hearts of men in the future, and we have a free country because of many of these things. But they were just obeying God, and they suffered because they loved God, and just how much that has spoken to me. The courage, the other thing I think of is the courage to speak to people about the Lord, and we have we're taught that all the time here, but. You know, it's hard for us to give a tract to somebody, but think about these folks and the testimonies of the very person you might be witnessing to be the person that turns you in, and they imprison you because they may be a spy, and they would turn you in for witnessing to them, and yet they were never afraid to tell as many people as they could about the Lord, and that has spoken in my heart, and I just thank the Lord for that. And I won't take the time to talk about how the wonderful way that God used the Baptists to secure our freedoms in this country. And convince the men who created our nation of religious freedom. And so I just to close and read that verse again, they were stoned, they were sawn asunder, they were tempted, were slain with the sword, they wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented. And here's the phrase that just jumps out to me every time I read this, of whom the world was not worthy. And that is true. The world is not worthy of these great Baptist Christians that paved the way for us. And I just want to thank the Lord this morning for how He has used our Baptist heritage and Baptist history in my life to bless and encourage me and draw me closer to Him.